So I'm just gonna dump this load of grain and come back over. Field 11's corn too, so.
Are you bringing combine then?
I'm just dumping this truck now.
Yeah, well, why don't you bring it back? By the time you get that combine over here, we'll have field 6 done. I really shouldn't have drove the combine all the way up there to see if the head was going there. So that was a long drive back to turn around and drive back up here. Mike, I got a big load for you.
Yeah, I see that.
Good thing you have a 1500 bushel cart, because with two of us running on corn, you're going to be moving.
Yeah, it's going to be busy.
Here, I'll flip the auger out. Make it a little easier. Don't want you to hit the corn head.
Okay, so this actually works. We're at 114,565 liters of corn.
What's the max on that bin site?
I think it's like 3.5 million.
Okay, good.
It's either 90,000 or 100,000 bushel I put that whole thing at. So.
So basically one big corn harvest is, we'll have that filled.
I don't think we have enough planted to do 3.5 million. But we won't have enough room for basically any, like, the rest of our crops, like beans and barley, so.
Basically you need to buy another bin.
Well, we had the small bins. It's 30,000 bushel bins by the small shed. So we still have that.
That new drive control really screws with me, because I go to hit like reverse and I've still got like the crew set, and all of a sudden I'll be going in reverse at like 10 yeah. mile an hour. Would you have to go in and change Joe to get the drive control to have one differential turned on all the time?
You go into like the LUA and it has like the standard like start settings.
Okay.
I could do that again, because I liked it having like being default with like four-wheel drive.
Yep, the shift four or whatever it is.
But I downloaded the newest drive control and it doesn't have that set up default, so I can like go back and change it, but I mean it's not the end of the world.
I do like the tracks. I mean it looks more realistic now in the cornfield that we have.
Yeah, I mean it always has that. Now we have to set up our wheels, so like you either have viable wheels or you know,
it's basic. The T450 row crop would have to have viable duals to work.
Or I think Decker made a wheel lane script for 15. It's a couple months old, but I have a feeling it's like the same one from 13 where you have to actually put it in like your lanes, so you don't have to have
that'd be nice.
Are you using the same line, Jake?
No, hip control too. I kind of changed it up a little bit.
Good.
Just
that's
doing
it works. It works perfect with the corn heads. That Mike takes the one lane and it's just a perfect distance away.
Oh my god, look at that 1500 Kinsey. Oh, there's a lot going on. We got a big train.
I got one of me dumping on Mike with the train going by. It looks pretty sick.
Yeah, I got one
too. Unload on the go. Like old times.
I don't have enough. Hold on, if you're gonna do that, Mike, go dump in the other truck and I'll meet you back at the top.
Can you move your spout?
Yeah, you should be able to move both. The only bad thing is if you want to move the tipper with the buttons, you run into the function of you're gonna close your tarp when you hit M. I noticed that. I was playing with it.
Oh, I have a conflict. on the...
Yeah, it's set up for J and N on the keyboard moves the spout.
I thought the cover was like Z or X.
It's no, the cover is N.
It's Z on mine, Jake.
It's N on mine. I must have to change that.
Like, it was N in single player when I was using it, but it's, I just found it Z today.
That's because you have another mod in your mods folder that's overriding the
input.
Yeah,
Raphael's cart.
I have the light so it turns on when you press B.
Yeah.
I don't know if I should keep it like that or if I should have it like something else so you can turn it on or off whenever you want.
That's not a big deal.
Yeah. You just need extra light in the day. Mike's blind.
Yeah. Our cart, the lights come on no matter what. As soon as you unfold the auger, the light will pop on.
That's the new John Deere's. If you have any of your lights in the cab turned on, like for driving, as soon as that pipe comes out, the light comes on.
Yeah, ours is a brand cart. So yeah, as soon as the auger unfolds, it could be the middle of the day and you don't have lights on, it'll come on.
Oh.
It's just the way that sensor's set up. The auger, as soon as the auger unfolds, it closes that circuit and turns the light on.
You should see the new Brett green, or the new J&M green carts are coming out. They came out with. They have a scale and an iPad in them. And basically, you go into the iPad, you can type the truck number or whatever truck name you want, your field name, and you hit how many pounds you want in there. And once you get your tractor over 1,000 PTO power, or RPM, it'll actually start dumping, shut the auger off at that, what you want it at, and then when he leaves and comes back, all you have to do is hit that truck, and it'll bring it up, same poundage, and you dump, and then at the end of the day, you can shoot it back home to your files.
Really? Yeah. I think the scale on ours, I think you can do... I don't think it's quite as high tech as that, but you can set the amount that your truck will hold and everything per crop. But I haven't played with it enough. I just wanted to get used to it. But yeah, you can put the field name and the truck name and all that stuff in.
Yeah, one of our farmers had it. He was showing me stuff when I was riding in the cart waiting to get loaded. And he goes, yo, watch this. 55. Boom. Turned it on. It turned it on automatically. It's like, damn, that is nice.
So it saves your...
It'll save the pound from that truck, and every time you go to re-dump, you just hit, say, truck number 7. You hit truck 7, and it'll bring up the pounds again that you've last done, and it'll start dumping again. And
have, like, different capacity trucks, like trailers?
Yep.
You don't really have to pay attention. It'll just dispense, like, X...
Yep. And then at the end of the day, you can hit, and he goes, yeah, at the end of the day, you just hit export, and it sends it home to his computer for his files.
That's nice.
Yeah. He's got tracks on his case planner, on a 24-row planner. It's pretty sick.
I think that should be my next project, is exporting the updated DB120 and figuring out so the animation, like, fixing the folding animations so it doesn't...
Oh. Well, just think, now you have the animation to get the tracks worked if you ever wanted a 48 roll with tracks on it.
Yeah. Just use the Terra track. Yeah. I just never got around to doing it, so...
Could you imagine a 48 roll with individual moving row units?
I think it's gonna be sweet.
I think it's gonna cause a lot of butthurt. That kid today. I made a DB90. Yeah, you farted together a Lego model.
I don't have any chopped straw showing up in my game.
I do.
I just have the first round you did.
Huh. Yeah, I don't know. Every once in a while, it did it on mine when I play with Joel. Somebody made a post on there that their chopped straw wasn't working. But
yeah,
mine's
working.
I guess we'll have to see if Joe gets back if he can see it.
Well, the first field we did, number 7, it worked fine. And then you got into 6 here and it just stopped.
Yeah, I've run into that issue. Like when we were doing, what was it, 16 that night?
Yeah.
on beans. Yeah, it never showed up for me on that night. I think it's just different nights, maybe server issue.
I still don't know. The dual tires on the other combine still don't show up for me.
They showed up on mine today when I got in here.
I just put them back on because they weren't on for me.
They were on for me. When I moved it out. I had to sneak by the sprayer. I decided not to fold it up. I was too lazy.
Yeah, the dedicated server is very different from when, like, I'm hosting multiplayer.
Yeah,
like, when I host multiplayer, it works just like single player, you know?
Yeah.
The
dedicated server is
nice.
Really...
I like the dedicated server. I don't lag as bad.
Yeah.
And if Mateus wants to get on in the middle of, like, the night when we're sleeping, for his morning.
Or, like, I can upload a video or photos and it doesn't affect you guys at all, so...
I remember that. You tried to stream video. You can do what random Spark does and does live streams now.
I used to, but it like saves it and uploads it, so it's like, what's the point? Like, I'd rather just... And like, if I like minimize to like look at comments, it like stops recording, so...
No.
Like, I could like look at comments, but most of the stuff is just like retarded what they say anyway, so it's not even...
Is Joe in a combine?
Yeah, I'm slowly making my way over.
At least you went the right direction. I forgot to turn at field 12, so I had to go all the way up by the store to come back around. Can you imagine two Lexions with 16-row heads? Mike would have fun.
I mean, I think eventually we'll get there. Like, we'll probably transition into Cat and Lexion.
We're debating on what tractor you're going to buy to pull that 2623.
I don't even know yet. Like, I think it would look really good on the RT, but...
Oh, it'll look good on the RT or the Cat. I go, I don't think he's going to buy the T97, but I could be wrong if he wants to stick with New Holland for now. Just hit control 2, you should steal Mike's. I didn't save it.
Oh, the duels are showing up now.
Yeah, when we play server games, Joe's got to put them on for him to be on. Otherwise, they won't show for everybody.
Oh, okay.
Because Joe doesn't trust one of us enough to rent machinery, so... Don't take the first one, I'm coming back on. So 11? Yeah, 11's corn. Is it 10 corn too, or what did we put 10 as?
I'm gonna have to pick it up from you when you come over, because I can't get it.
No,
from...
10? It was 10 beans?
10's beans. Oh, Mike can save it if he's got it. Mike can save it under 6.
10's beans, 11's corn, 15's corn. I know that.
17's corn, I think. 24 and 14 are corn too.
Should be saved under 6, Joe. If you go first, then Mike can unload me. Or skip one, yeah, either way. He's gonna have to follow you more, because corn's yielding pretty good.
I got a chop straw.
Joe's got his beacons on still. Oh!
That didn't hurt me.
I think we're a little over the 9.
Well, this is just the working one that it gave me, so...
I don't ever trust that on the auto, the GPS. It's...
Oh, I do for the corn heads.
I found for disking with the 27. Especially if it's bad.
Yeah, Jake's really bad at it. It's definitely not. He trusts it too much.
I usually fall into the issue I have with grazing lanes on the back of the Kraus, and I try to set it up, and then I'm a little bit wider than what I need to be. Joe's got his pipe on him. That's right, he don't have the capacity I do.
No, I know.
He's got his hazards on. He must be over 80%.
I still had my road beacons on.
Did you go in and do something with the terrain in Field 7? You want me to go first so you can unload on the way back? Or not? I don't think we're gonna make it all the way to the other side.
I don't know.
I'm only at 40%.
Oh, Mike's at 62. Oops.
Oh yeah, I was looking at that too. Shit.
Come on, 1090 with tracks, catch Joe. Come on, get him.
I do like these New Holland combines though.
Oh yeah. You're such a dick for releasing in-game models, that's what people say.
Me?
Don't release the good shit.
There's nothing wrong with this. This is good. This is a good mod.
Oh, these. Once you fix like the folding side panel, the ladder. The only bad thing about the camera, like if you open the in-game, like the camera in the cab.
Yeah.
It's like see-through.
Yeah, that's weird.
I wonder who missed that lonely cornstalk. Mike, run it over. That's what my old boss told us when we were doing beans. If you see a couple beans standing in the middle of the field, run them over with the cart. I think everybody were just mad at Joe because they couldn't turn at 22 miles an hour anymore.
Yeah. Especially I did.
He's trying to make a 16-inch map, but you can see how that works out. Could you imagine Wind Chaser in a 16-inch map?
Good God, no.
Fields for days!
I don't know, I think it'd be fun, because, I mean, we're at realistic yields. I mean, the yields are a little bit high for northwest Wisconsin. We're at like 250 bushel corn back home, the average is like 170.
Yeah, but you're perfect for Iowa and South Dakota.
Yeah, this is like ideal harvest conditions, and I mean, yeah, bushels at 75 bushel beans, usually you're probably looking at 50, 60 bushel beans, but you know, we put a lot of money in the ground too, so.
I'm gonna let you go first. I'll top, or Mike at 97. Oh, Mike's at 97.
Perfect. Yeah.
Mike forgetting which truck he's going to.
Well, I'm going to fill this one. I didn't feel like driving all the way over there to get that one.
The nice thing is it doesn't trample the grass, though.
Yeah, that's good. You aren't even going to fill that in one shot. You really need to put your hazards and flashers on if you're on the road.
Yeah,
oh, God, you're picky.
Hey, Joe's picky, too. We can't drive through fields. You got to do it realistic.
Yeah, see, realistic, I wouldn't put my hazards on. I'm in a tractor. If they want to run into me, it's their fault.
Yeah, I know.
I think they would lose anyway.
We've done it. I've got caught on a state highway doing it, and he told me it didn't matter. He goes, if you're hazard.
Yeah.
Yeah, whatever. The question is if the GPS lines are still saved where we have our straight one to go on 11. I'll let Joe say that.
I think one is saved straight.
I think so.
There's a couple of them that are straight.
We tried a Glen Bar, Mike.
A little bit. I didn't get into it too much.
That swing auger he's got made in there to where the auger swings at the pin, that's pretty nice.
Yeah.
The trigger follows the auger.
You gotta actually get out of the truck and swing the auger underneath the truck.
Yep.
Yeah, he sent that to me. I just never had a place to put it on my map.
Yeah, you don't really have a decent bin site. But in Australia, they have a lot of those small bins for seed.
Yeah. Like, yeah, those types of bins he's got, we got, those are mostly like our fert bins and stuff like that. You guys might as well pop the trucks out of them.
What?
Well,
well, we're going, we're going to 11 after this, right?
Yeah. Might as well.
And then our work our way in the horseshoe fashion.
That's usually how we do it. I'll finish it up if you want to go start at 11. Well, I guess we do got to drive trucks back.
Yeah.
I'll take the half empty truck. No, I'll just start.
You guys are good, right?
He didn't even run over that one corn stop.
No, I know, I missed it.
Are we gonna have to hold our heads? That's not fair. God, that 1500 looks so good in game.
I know, it came out so much nicer than I thought. I might reduce the normal map on the decal because it's a little bit too obnoxious, but
the bolts really pop on it now.
Looks good. The 2623 looks so much nicer though.
We figured you weren't going to be on, yet you got to that point, you were going to go, I'm just going to finish this.
Yeah, I stopped watching the Packer
hey.
Game. What?
Don't drive away from me.
Oh, you're still dumb.
That's the curse of the Big Ben, Jake.
Yeah.
We have 49,586 in this truck.
49,586.
And the other truck is 53,684.
Okay, so you said 49 what?
Oh, Jesus. Here, write this one down. 53,684.
Okay.
And then.
Hey, Jake, I'm going to start it by the bolt landing over here.
49,586.
-299.
102.97. So we're at 216,000 already?
Yeah.
Damn. And that's off of
the two smallest fields.
Well, that's like 10 hectares. So that's like 25 acres?
Yeah. You gotta think though. Okay, so you have 100,000 space. Well, okay, so 100,000 space. Say you average 225 on corn. It's only 444 acres. Mike, you would follow me on this stuff. Good idea.
The motor's not coming back. one's my dog, and then I'm babysitting my parents' dog while they're in Mexico.
Ah.
Oh, hey, that would probably help if I set my settings back so I could drive fast.
I saved it as course one.
Okay.
This follow me seems to work better in multiplayer than it does in single.
I downloaded a new follow me, so I don't know what they updated, but it should be better, I think.
Because the trucks aren't bad. It's the John Deere, the S670s, light because they're so light in the back end with the header on it. If you take a corner too fast,
it just spins
too
out.
Too far ahead. Yeah, if you're too far ahead of the guy, he spins out. Yeah, it's working better than the trucks.
How do you get to the bolt landing again? Oh, never mind, I found it. It's nice, I can see your dirty tire tracks going down the road.
That is a nice feature in 15. Kind of curious what 17, what improvements they bring to 17.
Oh, I thought you meant field. Oh, they're really going to have to come up with something, because that cattle and crop looks pretty good with the season with snow.
That looks very promising. They have, like, soil management as, like, the main one of the main aspects of it, so.
Yeah. Or you're going to get every other butter little kid. I don't want to play with soil management. Why not? I never wanted to before I started playing with you. Then you kind of forced it on me.
Well, I mean, really, what's the point of all the tillage equipment, you know?
Like, yeah.
Yeah.
In farming, you spend half your time, you know, tilling in and managing your residue, so.
It just, I never got the hang of what you all needed to spread and spray until you, like, started giving hints, and I came, okay, now I understand. You want to have, like, 10 or 12 on P and K, or N, P and K, or N and P, so you can. So when it goes down, it's still at like 4 or 3 or whatever it needs to be.
Yeah. Cherokee Trail for sure. Nope.
You imagine bee harvesting with like 5 of us? That'd be fun. Two truck drivers, one guy running a lifter, and two running the boxes.
So there's a canning company. It's like Friday's Canning or something like that back home, and they like cut green beans with oxbow harvesters. I think that would be cool to have an FS, but then you need to make a whole new crop.
Well,
you can make it like a sugar beet where it like defoliates and stuff like that, and then.
Or if you could figure out a way to do like seed corn, where you get a higher price for seed corn because of that Fetrel J or whatever, Jameson Fetrel that's in that did the South Dakota map. He actually made it so you can pick ear corn in that game, in his map.
Oh, yeah?
Yeah. I seen pictures on his page. It's from Seattle. And then random sparks is from Brookings. I'm just gonna get his map and send you the fence line feed bugs.
I already have them.
Oh, JDM sent them to you?
No, I made them.
Oh.
They're up by the modern.
I like how JDM bashes traps. Ooh hoo hoo. Packers.
Yeah.
Right. 4th and 20.
Plus. All the way down to the 35.
What's the score? I'm not even watching it. I'm too like stressed to even.
20-13 Arizona right now. Packers got 30 seconds left in the fourth quarter, and they're at the 40-yard line. Or no, they're at 37.
That was a ridiculous play, to be honest.
There's gonna be 2 seconds left because it wasn't 7. didn't only do it 10 seconds long. Jeez, Joe, you're missing a lot on the outside.
Huh?
You're missing a lot on the outside.
Waiting for the green cart.
Yeah, I know, I know.
Sucks for you.
Are you guys close to the west side of the field?
Yeah. We're on the very far east side. But you can park them on the west if you want. I can make it over there. Probably be parking on the west side, because then they're easier just to depart. Patriots got lucky again. Be a fight to get Mike out of that green card now.
If we upgrade some horsepower, yeah, it'd actually be fun.
So you see Mike out there in the kitty hauling ass across the field.
That kitty's pretty fun to pull. I mean, that thing's a fun tractor.
You just can't take corners very sharp.
I wish I had more beefy, like, Cummins sound files, you know.
Yeah. I can't wait till they release that new 800 series in a year. They're supposed to be redesigning the hood.
Yeah, do you know if Rogator's gonna adopt the new hood design, like the 700 and 800?
I do not know for sure. Why are you going back to your Rogator instead of a Hagee now?
Well, I'm not really sure. I think, like, if I had a Rogator, then, you know...
I mean, a Rogator... still put a dry fertilizer box on the back and we can still spread fertilizer.
Yeah.
And you already got the frame almost built, don't you?
Yeah, I got most of the frame built and I just have to make the wheel, the frame, the axles for the wheels. And then
there
undercarriage
is
completely...
There is no axles, they're hydraulic motors.
Yeah, but where it, like, connects the wheels, they're, like, in the, like, there's these sleeves, you know, they go in and out.
Yeah, they go in. Caught it.
So, is Arizona gonna win?
Depends on if they're gonna go for two, or if they're gonna take the safe bet and go for one.
Are you kidding me?
They scored a touchdown?
Yeah, they had 5 seconds left. He threw it from the 37 on a Hail Mary, and they caught it.
They started on a 4th and 20 from, like, their own 10.
Honestly, just go for two.
This is gonna be bad.
That guy got up there. Holy shit.
Yeah.
James Jones.
Hold on. Hold up, Mike. We're cutting this one close. We'll just stop there. Joe's got a ways to catch us. He'll probably be full anyway.
Yeah, I'll just wait here. You can dump when he gets here.
I mean, I'm at 25%, so you guys could probably go.
I can't go anywhere. I've got trees.
Oh.
I was just going to try to get Mike a full load.
Well, it'll be full once Joe gets around, I'll pick him up and then he can fill it up.
This is like a normal farm where everybody's got one combine with a superhuman man, and they got one just with a regular extension.
Not us, all ours are the same size.
It's a touchdown. Oh, Jeff. A Walsh. Could you imagine that? How that would go? Playoff Shane Gilbert.
Then I'd have to go up here to see a fellow with the Saskatchewan, the Rough Riders. So what the guys did is some people dumped the load of cow shit right left on Dave's neighbor's yard.
Savage.
Why miss you?
Oh, how you blame Blair Walsh? He's the one that gave all the points in the game.
What's that mean? He kicked one earlier in the game, but releases in like 47 yards.
Yeah. But it's tough down to him. He's good. Because he would have missed one earlier in the game. Oh, he should have missed it.
I'll get it.
As soon as they do the Patriots thing and decide to kick it off,
yeah,
screw up. Really, to the corner seat. You need to defer, but... I like this little pond up here by the way. It'd be good fishing ground.
I want to till up that grass and plant it. This north part of 11.
To what?
Well, the same crop, you know, like we run corn again or something.
That ditch is pretty steep though, isn't it?
Yeah. I think you can leave the ditch in there.
Yeah, you wouldn't plow up the ditch. You just plow up where it's grass, where we're mowing it.
Yeah.
And then turn that into crop, you know. Well, we're at 7-1 over here, 8-2.
Joe's just finding stuff he can use at 26-23. That's what we did. We disc our grass like three times and go across it with a field of tennis here in the spring. Are we just gonna cut off a big square and make it smaller? How do you wanna do this?
What?
Just wanna move over like six passes and just hone
square it up?
Yeah.
To where we can get a long straight.
There you go, Jake. You have to go on my hazards on the
No, I mean like when we use the long, just go in the middle of the spot and just keep squaring it out. That way it's easier for Mike and then we're always on the upload side.
Alright.
I'll
just follow you.
I think you're catching me. We need a boat in that lake. Just as a
hey, Mike, you want to turn off that follow me? Because that costs like a buck a minute.
A buck a minute?
No. Or like a buck a second or whatever it is. It's like $2,100 an hour.
No, I need to lift my head. Okay, so count 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7.
Am I going on your outside?
Yep.
So I'm going left and you're going
super hard long left on the other side. So I'll be on your right side coming back.
Alright.
Well, this is a good picture coming over the hill. Mike would hate it. Like, you know, 16-year-old not a big thing. Why are you guys doing such a big hand? It's no fun. It's so
that 450 so looks small next to that 1500.
I've seen a guy put a 1300 Kinsey on a row crop dual John Deere.
Yeah, I mean, that one guy on our American Photos runs a 1100 on like a 300 horse tractor and it looks tiny.
Yeah. Oh my god, did you just see that play, Mike?
I kind of caught the end of it here. I didn't see it.
Watch the replay. He went like 84 yards on the first pass play in overtime. Down to like the 3 yard line.
The Cardinals?
Yeah. Oh, that was a 80 yard wide.
You know, I like Green Bay. I normally cheer, but I bet a buddy. We took a bunch of games in the playoffs here. And I take Arizona. And if the game goes in overtime, the bet doubles.
Well, if you're taking Arizona, I would take that bet too.
I already won the Patriots. I took the Patriots. I'm up $20 now. This is a $40 game now.
Not gonna lie, I made a grand on the Alabama game.
You what?
I made $1,000 on the Alabama game.
Really?
Oh yeah. I bet about $1,500. On the bowl games.
Nice.
Came out $3,000 ahead. We can either make a big square and make it smaller, or make this and go make it bigger. It's up to you, Mike.
I keep going like this. This works.
Then we can pick up the extra portion.
That you missed?
I didn't miss it. It was on the outside. Oh, I didn't miss the wall. The doors are already around. Shit. Good thing this thing's got tracks. Going in the mud by the lake.
Think of all the hours we spent spraying and tilling, and we're just finally getting to harvesting this like 2 months later.
Well, the server hasn't been up for a while. I think the server has been up, I just don't think anybody was.
Yeah,
Fitzgerald run the ball.
Yeah. They scored?
Cardinals win. Fitzgerald ran the ball in, I think.
I thought you get to, the opponent gets a chance to score too.
Not if it's a touchdown, only if they kick a field goal.
Oh really?
If you score a touchdown on the first drive, the team wins. If they score anything less than a field goal, then the other team gets a shot to either tie or make the touchdown.
Oh.
I like college football better. College gives each team a try.
I thought that's how it was.
No, not anymore, or not legally.
It's because it used to be like sudden death, like whoever scores first, but...
Yeah, and out college, went to, each team gets a try from the 25-yard line. So if first team scores a touchdown, second team's got to score a touchdown. So it's over.
I think that's how it works up here in the CFL, too.
Makes sense to me.
I'd say go to your right and take that burrow.
Yeah, that's what I was gonna do. I have to update my windows soon.
Get updated. That's right. I'm surprised that little Instagram video I did turned out as nice as it did. It's like the perfect tone of music. Too bad Instagram won't let you do 15 seconds of video. You can go dump or you can wait, Mike. It's up to you. I think this one's gonna be more than two trucks. Hey Joe, the fields look like when you first brought it over from 13.
Too bad we don't have yield loss, like, with MR, you know?
For what?
How 13 like, was?
Like the MR, if you go too fast to start shooting it up the ass end.
That'd be nice. But we're 6 mile an hour ain't fast.
Yeah, but I mean, if you had a small cleaning area, you put a bigger header on it, like, you could only chop at, like, 3 miles an hour. If you're in shittier crops, you could harvest at, like, 7. No.
Yeah.
With no yield loss.
We've done 200 bushel corn with a Lexion 780 with a 16-row head at, what was it, 8 mile an hour?
Oh, shit.
The Lexion's eat corn. Whoa.
Hi, Joe.
Run away! Run away!
Coming over the hill. Oh, shit.
So we're going to do the same thing here and work our way back?
Yeah, I'd say go up to that tree grove there and just take the... We'll just cut it down so then we'll only have to do the long rows then.
Alright.
And we'll just make that one smaller instead. Just like how we finished this last round. Just go all the way to the outside. I'll come in on the inside. I think
Carolina, I can't see that tomorrow.
I don't know.
I hope Denver can beat Pittsburgh.
Pittsburgh's beat up. They're missing quite a few guys, aren't they?
Don't know if Big Ben's gonna play, and I don't know if Antonio Brown's playing or not.
I thought they ruled him. I thought he was. I thought I read somewhere he's. Because there's. Who else? Who's the guy that got knocked the fuck out last weekend?
Antonio Brown.
Then there's somebody else that I saw pop up on my phone.
Big Ben.
Yeah. I thought it was. Is it the running back?
I think so. Maybe all three of them, you know?
Yeah.
That, everybody on that hit was that hit was intentional, whether you want to say it or not, that hit was intentional.
Oh, he drove his head right through the other guy's face mask.
I used my shoulder. Still, you don't drive your shoulder pad through somebody's head.
Wow, shoulder pad, yeah, that's how I used to play hockey.
Hockey is a little bit different. Those guys are expecting it. That kid was expecting
no.
Going the wrong way, but whatever.
I'm just going to clean up this and have Mike unload me.
I'll probably just follow you on that one since there's a bigger cutout. I don't need unloading yet.
Yeah, the attachable PTO is pretty slick.
I like it. Now we just gotta do it to the Baylors. Or everything.
Well, what? You know, we don't have much stuff that runs off PTO.
Baylor? Isn't the merger PTO?
Yeah, merger's PTO.
Baylor's PTO. The DN should be PTO.
I don't think the Oxbow merger's PTO.
Well, the Baylor and the DN should be.
The DN.
Some planters are PTO drive. Bet you that, well, I don't know what John Deere's are, but I know the Case 36 row is PTO drive. The only reason I know that is because I got to repo one. That was a brand new Steiger 600 inside of the number.
Really?
Yeah, repo a $2 million or over $1 million worth of equipment from this farm. 2 12 row case heads. 2 tri-fold Case Tiger mates, 2 Case 13 shank rippers, 36 row planter, Case quad track 600, and a silo hood.
Oh shit.
From the same farm?
Yep.
What'd the guy do, just give up?
No, they just don't ever pay their bill.
So then what?
And then the mediator company called to figure out how to get payments, and they told the mediator company to go get fucked. So they called my buddy and said, "Well, here's the repo. Go get him." Okay. He calls me up. You can drive tractor, right? Yeah. You know how to hook up a planter? Yeah. Okay, perfect. Come here.
Wait, the so what's a mediator company?
Like a loan company calls you to figure out how you're going to make payments so they don't repo the stuff.
Oh, and then they're like, go screw you. And yeah. They're like, going to repo you now? Why didn't the guy make payments? That doesn't make any sense.
Yeah, I don't know. Don't go all the way to the other guy. Yeah. Yeah, I don't know why they didn't make payments. Whether they had enough in land that they were not making payments, I don't know.
So then, what does that farmer do next season?
Going to a different dealer. Try to buy stuff back.
You'd have to miss a shit ton of payments to get repo.
Yeah. Yeah.
I mean,
repoed bikes, cars.
Why not just take out a direct operating loan? It costs nothing to borrow that. It's like 1.5% to borrow.
Yeah. at B-Dub while we were sitting there watching the fight, the UFC fight. Her Escalade was up for repo. We went to B-Dub's at 5:30 to get a table hooked up to her vehicle with the tow truck. And when we were ready to leave at 11:30, we went and asked for the keys.
You don't have it.
It's been on the tow truck for over 6 hours. We got it.
Yeah, that was your server, right?
Yeah. She was pissed.
I imagine she might be a little angry.
She's just like bringing food to the guys that's repoing her car.
No, it wasn't our server. It was the server next to us was the one we repoed. We tried to get her table, but she was full.
I can just see Jake doing that. Like, yeah, by the way,
we repoed your car. I think she owed more than what the car was worth.
Oh, really?
But her mom went in and paid it off. Taking bikes, that was funny. I had to ride on my buddy's bike to the gas station. Somebody told us the bike was there. So two dudes are riding on a rock truck, so I could go take a rock. Not one of my fonder moments.
Oh, whatever, Jake, you loved it.
No. My buddy goes, hop on the back. No, I'm not riding, bitch. Just do it. We only have to go a mile. No. What are you going to do? Let him ride your bike? No, I'll get on the back. So what you're saying is we want to try to get the NPK up as much as we do, so we don't have to spray so much in the middle of the season.
You want to front load it so you don't have to come towards the end of, you know.
Yeah.
Ideally, I want to end up at 7-4 with 70% moisture, I think. I think that's what the numbers come out to.
Well, that Patriot, you should front load anyway because they have front load options. Mine's front load on my Patriot. Pull up to the truck and right underneath the cab on your right
no,
side.
No, we load up the soil early in the season so we can go grow stages without...
Yeah, spraying. But, like in real life, you gotta spray crops twice.
There goes Mike.
You run the same tracks that you ran. And if you... It'd be nice if you can make the sprayer tires fit between the rows of corn.
Yeah.
Like in real life.
Mike, is that the first trucks from the field?
Yeah.
Alright.
Those are the first two trucks.
So we got 54, 6, 73 in both.
Yeah.
Are we writing this down?
Or? Yes, I am.
Okay.
54.
So we can probably almost get another truck and a half out of this field.
I still got quite a bit in the cart yet.
Are we gonna make a thing for this?
A what?
Field? It'd be awesome if we had to, like, keep track for, like, finance office.
Am I going on your right or left?
I don't know. Where's Mateus when you need him?
Feeding his parrot? Where's Raphael? Drinking beer somewhere. Him.
I bet he don't have good enough internet to do this.
Yeah. Julian's coming back in like a week. I asked him to look at the cart because the cylinders Me and Raphael can't figure out why the cylinders don't work on our grain carts.
Yeah, I don't know how Julian got them to work on that Bergman.
Yeah, so I don't know what... Because I have it set up just like, you know, my cultivators, planter, you know, everything else.
Mm-hmm.
It just doesn't work with the overloader script, so I'm wondering if he has his pipe unfold with, like, the, maybe, like, the pipe function? I don't know. Because, like, the cylinders don't recognize when you press X, you know? It doesn't recognize the overloading unfold.
Oh, yeah.
So I'm assuming... I have to go back and look at it. I'm assuming he's using, like, the in-game P, like, pipe to, like, open up your pipe or something.
Maybe.
I don't know.
Sure made quick work of this field.
Yeah, I mean, the 12 row, like, you don't think it's that big, but when you have two of them in the field, you're...
Don't really know if you need 16. It's almost nice having the 12 row, because then Mike doesn't have to offset his cart all the time.
I think if we were running two 16 rows, we'd be, you know, we would just be going, we wouldn't be, like, doing soybean and barley. We'd just be doing, like, corn and beans, basically. A lot of corn. Because that's about the same width as the MacDon, I think.
The 16, probably. Where's Julian's 645, or 45 MacDon?
Yeah, that's going to be so nice.
I found out if you're going to use a 45 foot head, you're going to have to go in and link the auger on the Lexion, by the way.
A little short?
It gets tight. Follow me, don't like it. You have to drive the tractor in front of the combine first.
Yeah.
And then scoot it over and slow the combine down, otherwise the tractor's gonna get... Probably because I was using the 9620. Where's that 9er X?
Those 9R cabins need some work.
I noticed on your RX that the cylinders on the side of the tractor don't move with it when it turns.
Yeah, it's not even fully scripted. It's not
scripted.
That's
the
why
9Rs
I,
are pretty nice.
That's why I never use it. I mean, all that's... It's just a new body and tracks. I mean, it doesn't have any, like... cylinders or IC or anything like that.
You still got Ago's good 8R?
Yeah, I have it. I mean, it's ready to get scripted. Right now it's just like bare bones basic, but gotta add in all like the IC stuff to it. But
I'm surprised he never made a big stink about American Farming Photography releasing his 7R and 8R.
Probably never even heard of them.
Probably, they're not as big a name as you. He found JDM one.
That guy cracks me up.
You touch my mod?
You no edit my deer.
Hey, perfect timing. Mike's just getting back.
I'm at 80. I'm gonna take this thin sliver on my right.
Okay, I'm gonna go till I get close to being full. Am I gonna have to stop?
Come on, baby! We need a couple more ponies under that hood, I think.
Yeah, need a T97 real tree camel. I don't know if the D97 big floater tire one would actually fit close enough to the semi to dump that Kinsey.
You'd have to really stretch that auger out. Or...
Well, is it that much bigger than the 9R?
Oh yeah, those tires are huge.
No, it's the same size as the 9R.
Oh, they
are? The 9R works fine.
Yeah, it's like it's exactly the same as the 9R, the wheel width.
They look bigger.
Man, we're just heaping this cart.
Slow down, turn. Shut up, Jake.
Oops.
Come on, get up there.
You ain't gonna be able to take her.
Well, 50, well, a triaxle like that, you shouldn't get more than 50. Because a B-train, you only get about 1,500 bushels in, don't you?
Oh, and around here, that tandem only gets like 1,000 bushels.
Yeah, that sounds about right.
And then the triple axle is 11 to 1150. And then when the guys are on the super, or the double with triples, like the double Cornhuskers, then it's like 1,800.
Yeah. Yeah, this thing holds 53, and I think what are the trucks hold 54?
Yeah. Still not bad.
I expect the Wilson trailers to have the heaped capacity, because the Wilson trailer said that thing can hold 1,600 bushel heat.
Do not drive down a weight limit.
Yeah, if you go to the water line, it only holds like maybe 1,100 bushel. But if you heap it,
yeah, I suppose. Yeah, legally,
do not
it's...
drive down a highway because you will be screwed.
That's the only reason why I expected at 54, because that's what it came out to, around like 1,600 bushel heaped at 8 inches or something.
That makes sense.
DOT? Never heard of them.
So I mean, I can lower it down, but I mean,
oh no, it's the truck's pretty much cheap, so it makes sense that you have it.
Yeah, so I added like a on the fill plane like 25 degree heap angle.
Okay.
So I mean, if you put the tarp on it, it's sticking out over the tarp. But yeah, it's full, definitely heap. So I think it's pretty accurate, and it's really heavy on that truck too.
Yeah.
If you load it up to 54.
It ain't like that fuck modding one where they can run, what is it, million liters?
No. Otherwise, 1,000 bushel would be like, what, 38,000, 39,000?
I think 32, whatever Raphael's card, I think it's like 33 or 34.
Yeah. So it's quite a bit less if you only put 1,000 bushel
on. Oh, yeah. Talk about a lot of trips. You ain't gonna be able to sell them. 1.8 million in 3 hours.
No. But the trucks definitely handle it a lot better, you know?
Oh, yeah. Joe's just gonna have to wait over there.
Yeah, it's a little bit big cart for that tractor, but...
Well, if you had really rolly hills, I could understand it. This is, it lugged pretty hard. that tractor.
I mean, we're not dealing with that much slope in our fields, at least over here.
No, but the edge of number 7 along the highway, I think that got steeper.
I raised like the 27, 28, 26 intersection, so.
Oh, all I know is I was hanging pretty sideways on 7.
Well, where is it? I think it's in field 2. There's a, right by the yard there, there's a nasty lip.
Yeah.
Yeah, you just take that and pick up. That's called fun.
End up in the horse barn?
No, I ended up in the lagoon the one night.
This idiot tries to jump the slurry pit with a full trailer of wood chips.
I almost made it, but my tires got.
You know, we're all busy like doing work, chipping, you know, and then we're like, where the hell we need another truck? Where the hell's our other truck, Joe? You need some help.
Put the backpack sprayer on the back of the T97.
Oh god. Send these two to go spray. All of a sudden I see the fucking quad track out in the field. I'm like, I thought I told them to spray. It's got that little backpack sprayer on. Burning up more fuel than.
Yeah. We got bored because only one person could spray, so we're like, oh, screw it, this is gonna be funny.
I see these idiots put the Pantera on the back of like the Dodge flatbed.
Joe did that little Dodge flatbed with the in-game Dodge. It had a ramp that could go down. If you drove fast enough, you could get the Pantera on the back and drive the Pantera back to the shop.
Yeah.
We did some pretty weird stuff on that game. We were logging, couldn't find our truck. Where the hell is he? The driver fell asleep with the truck in a different field. Trey, where you at? Joe, kick him. We need that truck.
Yeah. Those are fun days. And then everything just went... That D-Long leaked every fucking mod. Like, this is before I could even model. You know, it's like a year and a half.
Just be glad it was the issue of right at the patch when the chaser got released.
Yeah. Like, I just wanted to do MP because I've never done it before, you know?
What's the next corner?
That second patch really messed up everything. I think 15 is...
Quit.
Go ahead, wind chaser, make beans and alfalfa don't work.
Have you not looked at any of the other comments the last 4 years? It's only been on there like 100 times.
This wasn't a bad field to harvest for corn.
No,
yeah,
that was surprisingly
painless.
As awkward as it kind of is, I mean...
We never really had an issue with the draper, it's just... It's...
It's more of a pain to plant than anything.
Nah, more... Just wait till we got a spray with tire tracks.
Yeah, I always do one headland and then I GPS everything else and... Always,
no,
like, I don't know, it's you can see
life.
The fields that I sprayed. I did a pretty good job of not taking out too much, so.
You only do one headland in real life, so.
Yeah.
Really? We do two.
We do one down here. I guess I really, when I'm spraying weed, I don't need two headlands. Or when I'm spraying corn, I really don't need two headlands. Yeah. I
Yeah, but I spent some big money and bought that second combine there, Jake.
What?
Got a second header, the one that you're in.
Yeah.
And basically just have enough money to lease fields again so we can start doing tillage. We still have like $2.2 million in loans.
I thought something was giving us a bunch of money, or did you actually fix that?
What? Oh, the I had to fix the finance mod because it gave us back too much subsidy on our land. You know?
Yeah.
It gives you like 30% subsidy on easy, 20% on medium, 10% on hard, so. And I only had the tax, the sales tax at like 5%.
So yeah, but I thought you had to back that down because of how you were posting set up. Because didn't it cost us like $400,000 to move one grow stage?
Yeah, that was the lease, the land lease. It was way too high. I have it set at like $250 an acre to rent per season.
That ain't bad.
Before it was like $20,000 an acre. You know, because the standard grow stage is like a couple hours in the game.
Yeah.
And then here it's 30 days. So it was like 1,000 times more expensive than it should have been.
So we ain't going to be getting Alexion for a while.
Well, I'm banking on a big, great demand at Budweiser, you know?
Oh, for barley? Yeah. We're in a corn one. Because if you buy a 26-23, we're going to have a bigger tractor.
Yeah. So, I mean, if we were to trade in our two T400s and get a big one, we can cover just as much ground with the 26-23, you know?
Yeah, as long as we don't have to use the 2720. So, are you doing a 2730 or just updating the 2720?
I don't know yet.
So, what's the next field now for corn?
We had 17, 14, and 24 left, I think, of corn.
17 is going to be a lot of yield if that's a good yielding. If all the stuff is where it should be.
Yeah,
at least it's close to the farm.
I had to do 17. I sprayed 17, so.
Oh, you haven't fixed 17?